Following an attack on Lhubiriha Secondary School in Kasese by suspected ADF rebels that left over 40 people dead and dozens hospitalized, security agencies in the country are working around the clock to apprehend the attackers. In the latest details, police say the death toll has risen to 44 following the discovery of a decomposing body of a female student, plus the death of one of the victims who had been hospitalized.
So far, one of the victims, that is in Bambu, died from injuries, and then two have so far been discharged. Three still remain in hospital, that is at Bwera, Chirudu, and Mulago.
Enanga explains that out of the 17 bodies that were burnt beyond recognition, 11 of them have been identified after they matched the DNA samples of their parents and relatives. Reading out the list of the identified bodies, Enanga urged parents to collect the remains of their loved ones from Bwera Hospital mortuary. Six bodies remain unidentified. Police revealed that intelligence gathered indicates that a group of 20 to 35 ADF rebels crossed into the country on the fateful day, and with the guidance of a young boy, they attacked the school where they killed the watchman before proceeding to the dormitories where they butchered dozens of students. Several suspects have already been arrested in connection to the attack.
We learned that between 20 to 35 ADF rebel fighters crossed into Uganda through a crossing point we identified at Duduma. This is along the border, the western border of Uganda with the eastern border of DRC. And it is from there that they approached the school with the guidance of a young boy, according to the credible witnesses. This place is just 1.5 kilometers from the border.
Meanwhile, the police last week arrested a group of 9 people belonging to the notorious criminal gangs terrorizing business owners in Kampala, Wakiso and neighboring districts. The gang is said to be behind the attacks on mobile money agents.
To inform you that in the many operations, we've so far recovered 2 guns that were used in aggravated robberies and related murders. 8 notorious suspects have so far been arrested. We have 5 phones that were recovered from Kasanda and Mubende. And we also have 1 motor vehicle that has so far been recovered that was facilitating the movement of these suspects.
In other news, the Ministry of Internal Affairs has reported a surge in cross-border movements, especially between Uganda and Rwanda, following the removal of travel restrictions by the Rwandan government early this month. The ministry is also working around the clock to ensure that they iron out issues on the recently launched polycarbonate passports.
Reports of the embassy of Denmark turning down some visa applicants from Uganda who are holding our newly launched polycarbonate passports. We had a case of Ugandan gentleman, I think one, who had his visa application rejected by the Danish embassy because of holding a new polycarbonate passport of Uganda.
The ministry is also working around the clock to ensure that they iron out issues on the recently launched polycarbonate passports. Rachel Nashwala reporting for the news.